Let's learn how to perform server-side rendering with React.js. To follow along, you'll need Node installed. First, open your terminal, then create a directory for the project. I'm going to name mine React, and let's change into that directory. We'll be using Express to build our web application, so install it with npm. Once that's done, create a file named server.js and open it with your text editor of choice. First, require Express, and then instantiate the app. Next, create a route for the index page, which is designated by a forward slash. In the callback, it will respond with Hello World as the main heading. And we'll specify port 3000 for our web server to listen on. I'm also going to log the base URL to the console once the server has started. Let's save the file and return back to our terminal so we can start the server. Once it's running, we can open the URL in our browser. Also, I'm opening the developer tools just for reference. Go back to your terminal and press Ctrl+C to stop your Node server. So now, let's do some server-side rendering with React. First, we need to install the dependencies React and React DOM. Once that's done, let's create our component file and open it with our text editor. For the time being, we won't be using JSX because we're only refactoring that one element. However, we're still creating a React class because we plan to add more to it later. Make sure to export the component, which returns a React element of H1, with no props and Hello World as the text. Let's save our file and go to server.js. Here we'll require React, React DOM server, and our component. We'll update the HTML so React DOM server renders our React element to a string. Save the file and start the server again. If you go back to your browser and refresh, you'll notice that the page still looks the same. However, if you look at the Elements panel in the DevTools, you'll notice that there are data attributes that contain the word React. This proves that the React component was rendered on the page by the server. Now, let's add a few more things like a paragraph and a button to our component. Because there'll be more going on, I'm going to use JSX because I find it more readable. However, Node doesn't understand JSX, so we'll need a way to transpile them. We could create a build task that compiles the files before the server started, or upgrade Node's required with Babel. We'll do the latter so we don't compile additional files. First, we must install Babel Register and Babel Preset React. Once they're installed, open server.js and at the very top, add the Babel require hook for the React preset. Now, our component that's required later will be transformed by Babel. Save the file, open component.jsx. Here, we'll refactor our component into JSX. We're nesting our children in the root node div because render can only return one node. Now, let's add back our heading. Following that, we'll add a paragraph with some text. And finally, we'll add a button that has an onclick event handler. The event handler will trigger an alert. Save the file and start your server again. Going back to your browser and refreshing, we can see the updated text as well as our button. However, when we click it, nothing happens. Where's our alert? Well, our app currently doesn't have any client-side JavaScript because React DOM server only renders the HTML markup. In order to make our app universal, we'll need to build a JavaScript bundle that's loaded on the client side. Then our component will remount in the DOM, and our JavaScript features will be present in the browser. We'll cover that in the next video. But for this video, this is all it takes to set up server-side rendering with React.